can we do for you?
Greetings. Been working on this machine on and off for years. Hard to really test it without the raw materials from the mine. You're here now, though, so maybe that'll change. This beauty can take the azurite you find in there and turn it into flares and dynamite. Enough azurite, and I can make this thing more efficient than it already is. Able to hold a lot more sulfite, and able to make better flares and dynamite. Seems like the rain's brought out a few worms. Don't think I'm an easy mark, Exile. I've spent more than enough time around Exiles to know which way the dagger's pointing, and I'll happily give it a shove in your direction if you try anything wormy. I'm conducting a little dig, the sort of enterprise that could make someone with your particular skill set a very handsome living. Don't worry, you'll not be moving much dirt. No, no. Why smash rocks when you could smash skulls, eh?
I am Tasuni, he who peers into the gloom. Who hears the black hearts that thunder within the mountain deep? If you seek enlightenment, find a torch. If you seek to understand the nightmare, I can help feel your way through the darkness. Your holy mantle is stained with the blood of the countless, Templar. A sacrifice worthy of a god. Just not to the god you had in mind. The gate is open, and now I hear her voice as clearly as if she was sitting right here with me. Words of a dead woman, reverberating up from the depths of Highgate. A spirit chained, yet not enslaved, tortured, yet unbroken. That dead woman is Deshret, and our Red Sakema longs to return to the dust of her vestiary. Free her, and I shall reward you as my gifts allow.
This'll do nicely, Exile. This is the stuff. Good nose, Exile. You find more and I'll come right over. Don't touch it, though. Stuff will send you mad without the right precautions. You think I want to be dressed like this? tell you what. How about we take a look around my mine? Talk to me when you're ready to go. This is the Good find, Exile. Greetings.
Away at the roots of this mountain.
Thank you.
that suffer as you have, Deshret. Gather my will. Teetering on the brink of cataclysm. must have time to gather my will.
Rapture device has absorbed its fill of harvested life from fury and desire. It is ready. So am I. I know now that I was born to be the end and the beginning of the Empire. The Beast has made this clear to me, as clear and undeniable as the sacrifice I must now make. My Lady Diala, my love, my life's greatest achievement. She must leave me now, for she cannot follow, and she will perish if she remains. And so I will ask of her more than she would ever give. I will betray her. I will break her heart so that I do not break her soul.
You know, not a cockroach. Had I accepted my place, my rapturous role, the Beast would be no more, no less, no anything at all. My selfishness tickled the Beast's fancy and it laughed the world I knew away. Yet I have had much time to think on my lonesome, much time to wonder. Wonder if the Rapture really needs to eat a gemling queen. Maybe something else will get its catastrophic juices slathering. Something like eyeball soup. The eye of fury. The eye of desire. Pretty gems for our pretty designs. But where could they be? Don't fret now. I have my suspicions. Calm, the sovereign of slaughter. He remains and suffers his delusions right here in the halls of nightmare. Fury is all he knows, so fury Calm will have. Daresso, King of Swords, damned by desire. Oh, aren't we all? He's down here too, and desire's curse remains his to bear. Go on, not a cockroach. Bring me the crown jewels so that we might wake the Rapture and finally put an end to this pestering beast.
Daresso, the Sword of the King. It was here in the pits of Theopolis that I made my name, killing rabid dogs and wild boars before I could even be considered a man. In this so glorious of arenas, I care nothing for your past, only your future. And for that, you will have to fight.
Well.
gutters, steal your bellies, for the slaughter is at hand.
Thank you.
gather my will.
Age 13, carving knife in hand, I killed beasts for the amusement of the filthy. At 15, they thought me worthy to fight a fellow man. A butcher he was, twice as big and twice as stupid as I. I butchered the butcher, and many like him, earned my way, kill by kill, out of the awful pit and into the grand arena. I thought I would find wealth and glory in the arena. I was wrong. I found something far more precious. My Lady Mervais.
Time to gather my will.
strike and kill the man with his own dagger. Fighting had always been about survival, the primal instinct to kill or be killed. Now, the fight became about something else.
battle worthy of song. The way you fight reminds me of how it feels to be possessed with the idea of victory. Is your passion enough to claim a crown? We shall see.
The previous King of Swords was a giant of a man, both faster and stronger than I. Yet I needed only look up at my Lady Mervale to know that I had no choice. I could not die this day. I made a shield under every parry, striking with all my might so that my arms felt they might snap with every impact. I stepped inside his faltering swing, and I slit the giant's throat. Cried out for my lady's hand. From that day forth, I wore the crown of swords upon my head and the ring of eternal love upon my finger.
More glory than they ever earned in life.
I felt it, saw it. The storm of her release. Our red Sakema is free to mingle once more with the red earth of her birthplace. Deseret was the howling wind, the lash and bite of the driving dust. Our wild Vestiri is weakened by her absence no longer. You've done yourself proud today, Exile. Righted a wrong that we Mordekaiser have borne for far too long. And of course, as promised, you shall be rewarded.
The desire from Daresso's dead hand, did you? Or is it dead again hand? Or re-dead hand? Or is undeath really just death with benefits? In which case, you didn't kill Daresso because he was already dead. It's all a bit of a grey area, really. I'm completely beside the point. Old axe for brains. Calm had Eternals dragged from their homes all over the South Coast. Like sheep, he butchered them, no matter how desperately they bleated. He adorned his doorways with the heads of women and children. What makes a hero or a villain? It depends who you ask. Yet we're still one gem short. Go. Not a cockroach, and relieve Calm of his fury.
Deseret has ascended and returned, as we all must, to the dust of Vestiri. The Red Sakema's dishonor has passed, and for that outsider, I will always be grateful. Yet honor lies not in whether an act is committed. Honor lies in how an act is committed. What does it say of the Mordekaiser when we are forbidden to attend to our own? What does it say of Oyan and her belief in her own blood, our own honor?
offering left to us by two. I dreamed of my ancestors' halls. They were empty. I dreamed of the north, of an offering left to us by Tukuhama. An offering that will save the Karui. I needed only to take it. I gathered my finest 500. I brought them here. I claimed what Tukuhama had promised me.
Time to gather.
crushed the servants of Kitava beneath our heels as we marched across the land. I allowed not one of my 500 to fall. The blood of the ancestors surged in our veins, and each and every one of my warriors earned Tukohama's mark upon their skin. We descended into the heart of Rayclast, and there he came to me, Tukohama. He asked of me a sacrifice. I gave it willingly. My axe fell 500 times, the jade drinking its fill of Kardui blood. Tukohama was pleased.